Question number 141. Select the incorrect statement with respect to a hormone. And the options given are non-nutrient chemical, act as intracellular messengers, produced in trace amounts, and the last option is released into blood and transported to a distantly located target organ. Now, hormones are non-nutrient chemicals which act as intercellular messengers and are produced in trace amount. So, the very first statement, non-nutrient chemical, is a correct option because hormones are non-nutrient chemicals which act as intercellular messengers and are produced in trace amounts. The next statement, act as intracellular messengers, is an incorrect statement and is a correct answer to our question because hormones are intercellular messengers. The next statement, produced in trace amounts, is also a correct statement, so cannot be a correct answer to our question. And the fourth statement, released into blood and transported to a distantly located target organ, is also a correct statement and cannot be a correct answer to our question. So, the correct answer to this question is option number 2. Let's discuss our next question. Question number 142. Thymus gland is a lobular structure located between lungs, behind blank, on the blank side of aorta. Choose the option which fills the blank correctly. And the options given are clavicle, dorsal, second option is clavicle, lateral, third option is sternum, ventral, fourth option is sternum, dorsal. Now, this statement is given in your NCERT book that thyroid gland is a lobular structure located between the lungs, behind sternum, on the ventral side of aorta. So, among the given option, the correct answer to this question is option number 3, sternum and ventral. This is the correct answer to our question. Whereas option number 1, clavicle and dorsal, is an incorrect option. Option number 2, clavicle and lateral, is an incorrect option. Option number 4, sternum and dorsal, is also an incorrect option. And the correct answer is option number 3. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 143, choose the correct statement. And the very first statement says, rods are functional in daylight while cones are exclusively operational in dim light. And as it is an incorrect statement, this cannot be a correct answer to our question. Because rods are functional in dim light and not in daylight, while cones are functional in daylight and not in dim light. The next statement says, depolarization of sensory hair cells present in cochlea takes place by closing off mechanical gated potassium channels. And this is also an incorrect statement. Why? Because depolarization of sensory hair cells present in cochlea takes place by opening off and not by closing off mechanical gated potassium channels. The next statement is, an action potential in a cyton causes endocytosis of synaptic vesicles, which triggers impulse conduction in the axon. And this is also an incorrect statement, because an action potential in a cyton causes exocytosis of synaptic vesicles at the synaptic cleft, which triggers impulse conduction in the successive neuron. The last statement is, in the knee-jerk stretch reflex, stimulus is the stretching of muscle and response is its contraction. And as it is a correct statement, this is a correct answer to our question, because this knee-jerk reflex stretch is a monosynaptic reflex. And the stimulus is the stretching of muscle and response is its contraction. So, the correct answer to this question is option number 4. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 144. select the mismatch with respect to joints in humans. The very first match given is saddle joint, and the match is between carpal and metacarpal of thumb. And as it is a correct match, this cannot be a correct answer to our question, because saddle joint is a type of synovial joint which is present between carpal and metacarpal of human thumb. The next match given is pivot joint, and the match is between atlas and axis. And as it is also a correct match, this cannot be a correct answer to our question. It is also a type of synovial joint present between atlas and axis. The next match is hinge joint, and the match given is between humerus and ulna. And as it is also a correct match, this cannot be a correct answer to our question. Another type of synovial joint which is present between humerus and ulna. The last match given is gliding joint, and the match is between phalanges. And as it is an incorrect match, this is a correct answer to our question, because gliding joint, simplest type of synovial joint, is present between carpals and not between phalanges. On the other hand, hinge joint is present between phalanges. So the correct answer to this question is option number 4. All the type of joints given are synovial type of joint, but the incorrect one is the last option. Now let's move on to the next question. Question number 145. Which one is an age-related disorder characterized by decreased bone mass and increased chances of fractures? And the options given are myasthenia gravis, osteoporosis, arthritis, gout. Age-related disorder characterized by decreased bone mass and increased chances of fractures. And the correct answer to this question is option number 2, osteoporosis. Because decreased level of estrogen is a common cause of osteoporosis in females at menopause. It's because of low estrogen levels. Now let's discuss the rest of the options. The next option is myasthenia gravis, and this is an incorrect option because myasthenia gravis is an autoimmune disorder that affects neuromuscular junction, leading to fatigue, weakening and paralysis of skeletal muscles. The next option is arthritis, and this is an incorrect option. Arthritis is inflammation of joints, whereas the last option, gout, is also an incorrect option because gout is inflammation of joints due to accumulation of uric acid crystals. So the correct answer to this question is option number 2. Let's move on to the next question.